Hello and welcome to a special feature here on CTI Group's YouTube channel meant to celebrate women. In this video we will talk about the many wonderful women who have left their footprint in the industry in honor of Women's History Month. As with most industries of the world, the cruise industry is male-dominated. However, more and more women are moving up through the ranks and breaking down invisible barriers set by gender issues. Now in 2021, we are able to say that there is a handful of women in top positions, something that was unheard of 10 years ago. There is Lisa Letoff-Perlow, the first female CEO in the industry, who is head of Celebrity Cruises. Christine Duffy, president of Carnival Cruise Line since 2015. Jan Swartz, president of Holland America Group as of 2020. Then come some high-ranking positions out at sea, most notably being the female captains, of which only a handful exist. Karen Starr Jansen, first woman captain of a mega cruise ship in 2007. Kate McHugh, first American female captain since 2015. Belinda Bennett, first black female captain as of 2016. None of these women were able to get to their current positions without hard work and determination. For many of them, it was unusual to see other women in power as they worked their way up, unheard of even. Starting with Lisa Letoff-Perlow, she began her road to success working in a travel agency. After about a year, she found herself with the opportunity to get a sales position at Royal Caribbean Cruise Line. Despite being rejected at first, she persisted and tried again, landing herself the job. From there, it took a long 30 years to become the CEO of Celebrity Cruises. On top of being an excellent leader, she also acts as an advocate for women in the industry with feats such as being chairwoman of the Extraordinary Women Leading Change Advisory Board and appointing Kate McHugh as Celebrity's first American female captain. Moving on to Christine Duffy, she was appointed CEO and president of Carnival Cruise Line in 2014. Originally, Duffy wanted to become a flight attendant, but after being rejected in the last stages of hiring, she moved on to working for travel agencies. She remained there for many years before entering the world of cruising. Prior to her Carnival presidency, Duffy was made CEO of Cruise Lines International Association in 2011. She has worked hard to get to the position she is in today and continues to speak up for women in the industry. In an interview, Duffy once said that helping other women see the possibility of what they can do is important. Next, we will talk about Jan Swartz. In December 2020, Swartz was made president of Holland America Group. She had her start in the company in 1997 as a management consultant. Just as with everyone else, Swartz made her way up through the ranks, landing positions such as vice president of strategy and business, followed by vice president of customer service. In 2013, she was made president of Princess Cruises, and then, in 2016, president of Carnival Australia, on top of Princess. It took her 12 years to land her role as president of Princess Cruises. Another impressive achievement of Swartz is that she is a member of the Committee of 200, known as the C200, which is an organization of successful women in leadership roles of business. Outside of these amazing accomplishments on land are those that take place at sea. Strides have been taken to increase the percentage of female crew members, especially in higher positions. Karen Starr Jansen was named the first female captain of a mega cruise ship. The ship she was put in charge of was the Monarch of the Seas with Royal Caribbean in 2007. Starr Jansen had her start at sea on a petroleum tanker in a low-ranking position when she was only 19. She remained on petroleum and chemical tankers for several years before moving on to cruise ships and working her way up to the remarkable position of captain. In 2010, she also captained the ship that delivered hurricane relief to the Caribbean. Next, we'll talk about Kate McHugh, the first American female cruise captain. As mentioned before, Lisa Letoff-Perlow is the one who appointed her as captain back in 2015. After finishing her schooling at the California Maritime Academy, McHugh began as a third officer in a different cruise line before moving to Royal Caribbean and moving her way up in the ranks. The first ship she was set to captain was the Celebrity Summit. McHugh was also head of a monumental moment in the cruise industry when, on International Women's Day in 2020, it was announced that she would be captaining the Celebrity Edge with the first ever all-female bridge crew. Although the ship was unable to sail due to the pandemic, it was still a huge step forward for women in the industry. The last captain we will discuss is Belinda Bennett of Windstar Cruises. Bennett prides herself on being the first Black woman to become a captain. She was appointed to this position in 2016 on the MSY Windstar. Bennett's journey at sea began when she was only 17 as a deck cadet in the yachting industry. Being from the rather remote island of St. Helena, Bennett made her journey possible through determination and a refusal to give up. Despite having faced both racism and sexism on her way through the ranks, Bennett has said that she has never let it be an issue. In an interview, she stated, "Being a woman, you have to work extra hard to prove yourself, even more than a man. Some men might not like that, but that's the way it is. Work hard, be strong, and don't let anything deter you. I've done it. You can do it too." Captain Bennett's words, along with the words of many other successful women in the cruise industry, are meant to be heard. It is success stories like these that empower women and allow them to dream big. One interesting story is that of a hotel director from Celebrity Cruises, Nina Hotanini. Back in 2005, she had noticed that the required uniform of women on board were skirts. So, at a captain's conference, she brought up this issue by simply asking, "Why can't we wear pants?" Some men at the conference did not even understand the question. It was Lisa Litoff-Perlo who had given Hotanini a note the next day stating that the pants issue was taken care of. A few months later, celebrities' uniform policy changed for women. Women have always been facing hardships at sea. A long time ago, it was actually considered bad luck to have a woman on board a ship. People believed that women were a distraction to the male crew members, which would anger the seas. Keeping that in mind, it is amazing to see how much has changed over time. As we move towards the future, we encourage more women to step into this industry and make a name for themselves. Nowadays, there are endless possibilities for women in the industry. If these women who started in low-ranking positions could work their way up, then so could any other determined woman. Here at CTI, we are searching to hire more women to lessen the gender gap within the industry. We hope you enjoyed this video and learned a bit more about these powerful women. Be sure to share this video with your friends. Remember to subscribe and hit the notification bell to be updated on when we release new content. Thanks for watching and have a great day.